Welcome from Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk a little bit about how we draw sp3 hybridized atoms. So in the upper left, we've written sp3. And remember, to get sp3 hybridization, we're going to take all four of our valence atomic orbitals in carbon, s, the px, the py, the pz, and we're going to combine them to get four sp3 hybrids. These sp3 hybrids have access to all three dimensions. They have x properties, y properties, and z properties because we use the px, py, and pz. So in order to draw these, we have to draw them in a three-dimensional sense on a two-dimensional surface. And that's a little tricky. Two of our bonds or groups will be in the plane of the writing surface, and two of the bonds or groups, lone pairs, will be out of the plane of the writing surface. This is a pretty typical way we'll draw this. So I've drawn this dot, that's our central atom. Coming off of this dot are two groups, bonds, lone pairs, that are in the plane of the writing surface, and we've drawn them normally. And the two out-of-plane groups we draw coming off in about the same direction. We draw one of them kind of dark, and we all draw the other one kind of dashed, and I'll talk about that in a second. The dark one we call a wedged group, and the one that has the lines, we call it a hashed group. The hashed group is back in the plane of the paper, and the wedge group is sticking up out towards us. So let's look at methane. So we're going to have a carbon, and we will draw two lines coming off of carbon. Those are two of the hybrids. They are connecting to two of our hydrogens. And then we will draw over here a wedged bond, and here is a hashed bond to the other hydrogen. Note that we draw these two groups kind of close together. They're a little squished together, and we're trying to represent as close as we can this being about a 109-degree bond angle. We don't have to draw everything in exactly this orientation. You know, we could draw this upside down. As long as we have two lines within the plane of the writing surface at about a 120-degree bond angle, and then we have one wedged and one hashed, and there's our tetrahedral methane. Now, for drawing ammonia, we're going to draw the exact same picture. Let's draw these bottom hydrogens on carbon in the same way on this nitrogen. So there's one of our in-plane bonds, there's one of our out-of-plane bonds, the wedged one, and there's the hashed one. And coming off the top, we need the lone pair. Now we're going to draw this lobe to represent the orbital, the sp3 hybrid orbital that holds that lone pair. Again, we could have the lone pair coming off in different directions. We could have it instead going back into the plane of the paper, and we could draw the border of that lobe hashed. It's a little awkward, but we can do it. So finally, we have water. Water is going to look very much the same. This is one way you might draw it. Have the two in-plane atoms being in-plane bonds to your hydrogens. And then that means one of the lone pairs is going to be coming towards us. We'll try to draw it wedged. And the other lone pair is going back into the writing surface. We'll try to draw that hashed. Another way a lot of people would draw this is keep the hydrogens in the plane of the surface and stick our lone pairs out on top like this. That's an ugly wedge, but I think you get the idea. And there's the hash version. So a lot of ways we can represent these, but this is how we show sp3 hybridized atoms. The challenge is they occupy all three dimensions. So we have to somehow communicate them, these three-dimensional atoms, in a two-dimensional surface.